Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lena. Thank you guys so much for clicking on this video. Today's video is gonna be another classroom haul. If you haven't seen my last classroom haul, I will link it up right here. But I'm super excited for this one because I have a month and a half until I'm in my classroom, and the goodies I have in front of me, I've had my eye on for a long time. So if you guys want to see what I have, then just keep on watching. Okay, the first thing I got are pencils. These are pre-sharpened pencils. I got them off of Amazon, and I think I have 240, which is a lot, but these are my favorite types of pencils. I have always used these and I'm really excited because they are pre-sharpened, so I don't have to sharpen them once I get into the classroom. So I have a bunch of these. There are four boxes of these, and they're 60, so yeah, 240 pencils. Okay, so the second thing I got are these googly eyes. I feel like you see these in every single teacher Instagram and every single Pinterest board, but I've had my eye on these for so long. They've been saved in my Pinterest board forever, but I am planning on doing the look with the two O's as the googly eyes. I will insert a picture right here for you guys if you want to see kind of what my vision is, but I'm super excited about these. There are four in this one, so I can always save the other two for when these two start to get really dirty and bad. So I'm super excited about these. Okay, next I got a staple remover. This is a staple in a classroom. but this one is magnetic and it's super easy to hold, as you can see. I don't know if you can see, but since it's magnetic, the staples actually like collect themselves. So when you do bulletin boards or something, it can be very easy to get the staples out. So I feel like this is a must in a classroom. Okay, the next thing I got is another must-have. This is a stapler. So as you saw in my previous haul, I had those two silver staplers, but those are gonna be strictly for my students to use, and then I'm gonna want one for me that's strictly gonna be for me. And so my cooperating teacher actually had a spring stapler before, and then I was watching another video about classroom haul and I saw this and there was a link to it, so I'm super excited because it is a spring stapler, which means that like you put barely any pressure and it staples it. Super nice. So this one is gonna be for me and me only. Okay, so the next thing I got is for my whiteboard. It's part of my whiteboard organization. And so when I got this, I thought it was magnetic because I thought that where I got it from, the link, that she was using it as magnetic, but it actually does not come magnetic. But you can easily put magnetic tape on the back of it and stick it to the whiteboard. But I don't know if you can see this, it's still in the packaging just because I don't want to get it to get ruined before I get into my classroom. But basically this is where you put your Expo markers, you can put your eraser. I will insert another picture right here of kind of what my vision is. But yeah, I'm honestly just gonna put a magnetic tape across this so it sticks onto my whiteboard. All right, next thing I got, I'm super excited about, and it's something that I've been wanting for a long time that will fit in this little cabinet right here, and that is my Mr. Sketch markers. I'm super excited about these because they're just beautiful. Every teacher has these, and so I feel like it is a must to have. I am a teacher who plans on using anchor charts a lot, and I'm super excited about them, and so I want to make sure that I have colorful markers to use on my anchor charts. So Mr. Sketch markers are a must as well. So the next thing I got is something for math. So in third grade, the students start to learn about fractions, and my cooperating teacher actually had this game in his classroom, so I went ahead and picked it up. It is called Fraction Dominoes. So the ages say 8+, and then the grades, you can start in third grade and go all the way to seventh grade, and then you could play one to four players. This is gonna be a great game for my students to play. So when I was student teaching the kids who did do this, it was tricky for some kids, but if you have students who are really good at fractions and need something to spice it up a little bit, I really recommend this game. It is awesome, and so I will go more into depth about it once I do start teaching fractions and once it is being used in the classroom. So the next thing I got is a wireless doorbell. I'm super excited about this because you see it everywhere, and also it's something that can grab the students' attention really quick and makes transition times very smooth and quickly, and so this I feel like is perfect. So I'm super excited about this. It's a doorbell. All right, so the next thing I got is a mini shredder. I don't know if you've seen this on Instagram. I forget who posted it, but when I saw this, I immediately needed it. So basically what it is, it's a shredder. So you just put the paper in and you shred it and it goes in, collects it. So what I plan on using this for is for my students who have a lot of anxiety or a lot of worries that they need to get off their chest but don't want to tell someone or don't want to voice it. They can write it down and then shred it so that no one can read it, and it's something that helps with getting things off your chest rather than keeping it inside and getting upset about it. And so I want them to use this as much as they can. And I also want them to know that they can also come to me and talk to me about some of the issues or problems that they're having. But I do want this here for students who just really quickly want to write something down and then shred it away. So yeah. And then I made this on PowerPoint, but where I found it on Instagram, I will link the Instagram post down below, but where I found it on Instagram, I think she was selling this on TPT, I'm not quite sure, but I went ahead and made it myself because I recognized the fonts that she used, and I just created my own blue colors. So I'm super excited about this. But yeah, cute. All right, so the next thing I got are these answer buzzers. There's four of them, they're different colors, and each of the buzzers comes with their own unique sound. And so this is really great. I can use this in small group or whole group instruction. So I'm really excited to see what I can come up with using these buzzers, but this is gonna be so fun in the classroom. Okay, so the next thing I got is this magnetic rod. So you can see that it's magnetic and you can adjust it. But I am planning on using or displaying my anchor charts with these and also displaying the date with these. So I don't know if you guys have seen this, but you use this on the whiteboard and then you have the month, the day, and the year in binder rings. So then it's just super easy to flip to the next month, flip to the next day, and the next year if you need to. So I'm planning on doing that. So I'm definitely gonna need to pick up more of these, but I wanted to just get one because I know that they sell a lot of different kinds of magnetic rods, and I really like this one because it's super easy to adjust, and then once it's on the board then it won't move. But then I've also seen teachers use these on the wall to display anchor charts, and so because I am gonna want them like maybe on a bulletin board or something with my anchor charts, and so I have an idea of putting magnetic tape on this and then taping it to the wall. So I'm hoping that works. If not, I think I might use something else to store my anchor charts, but I really want to see if this does work because I'm really planning on having my anchor charts displayed on the wall for the kids to look at. All right, so the next thing I got is this magnetic pocket folder thing. I got two of these. They're just white and it's a big, huge magnetic square on the back. And so this is perfect because I can put this on my whiteboard to store papers that I need quick access to, or I can put this on the whiteboard and then write like something above it to indicate like this goes to a certain center or a certain group. So I can use these a lot. So I might pick up some more of these from Amazon. I really like them. I like how sleek they are, and I can easily put vinyl on this. So, and it's pretty big. So yeah, this is a really good find. All right, so the next thing I went ahead and purchased is something that I got from my cooperating teacher. So he had purchased these for his students. These are writing process folders. So these are super amazing because they open up like this and then like this. But this is awesome because it has everything you need for writing on it, and it's at the, it's right for the students. It has a checklist, it has editing marks, and also he used this as a like test protector. So he'd be like, get out your writing folders, and they could cover their test with it. So this is perfect. It has many uses, and I am definitely going to be using this for my students' writing, collecting it all in here. So I went ahead and purchased 24 of them. They do come in a pack of 12. So I purchased two packs of 12. So I'm super excited for this. This is the first thing that I actually have planned for organization with my students. I think that I'm gonna have them use this and then a binder that has their math and ELA in it. So I'm still trying to figure that out, but I'm really excited that I at least have this for them to use. Okay, so the next thing I got are these stools for my small group table. They looked like this. And this is actually plastic right here. I know you can find these at IKEA, but these are not IKEA. I found these on Amazon. I will link them down below, but I like them because it's not metal on top, it's plastic. I don't know if the IKEA ones have plastic as well, but I'm super excited about these because they're gonna go around my small group table. So I have 5 of them, that which means that my small group table is gonna be about 5 students each. So yeah, I'm super excited for these to go into my classroom. All right, so the next thing I got is, actually didn't get it, I found it in my house, but this is what it looks like. It is super cute. I am actually obsessed with it. I was in my backyard the other day and I saw this and I grabbed it immediately, took it into my room and just kind of wiped it down because it was outside and there was a lot of dirt on it. But I'm super excited about this because I think I'm gonna put, go on my Cricut and write welcome in vinyl and put it outside my door. I think it is just so cute. It totally goes with my theme of farmhouse and stuff. So this is going to find its home in my classroom and I am so excited. All right, so the last thing in my classroom haul is this Better Than Paper bulletin board and the design white shiplap. I'm super excited about this because it's kind of what sparked my interest in the entire farmhouse theme for your classroom. I was watching a lot of classroom setups last August and September, and a lot of teachers were using this, and I just love it. One in particular, Janice Wong, her bulletin board is just so beautiful. I will insert a picture right here. But yeah, I just, once I saw that bulletin board, I saved it. I took a screenshot and I need it in my classroom. And I'm so sad because she has to take down her classroom. And so she has to take down that bulletin board. And I just am so sad because she said that it took so long. And so, but I am prepared for that. I'm prepared for the work and the patience to make that bulletin board because it is so cute, but I'm so excited. All right, guys, that is the end of this video. I hope you guys liked it. I am super excited for all these things to find their home in my classroom. And I hope you guys got some ideas and inspiration from some of the things that I purchased. So I can't wait for this school year and I'm so excited. So if you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, comment down below, subscribe, and follow my teaching Instagram at Lena Loves Teaching. All right, you guys, I will see you next time. Bye.